Hello, Ranos here, and welcome back to the episode of Satisfactory. Where I got all the materials needed, now I've figured out how to get my base go higher. We first place down one of these, and then, like that, and you do that. There are four different levels. It's really tall, but I need that one. So, how about we link that to this, since this is going to be going towards the this thing. So that way though, needs to be like about there. And now, let's get it set to do its thing, which is that thing. Okay. Now that needs to go all the way down here. Oh, balls fell off. That looks fine. And you, there. Now all you do is put power into the thing. Also need to get a container. Need to make this thing a bit bigger. Because it's right on the edge. I wonder if it would have been just fine further back. Probably needs some more flooring anyway. So put you there. Put you there. Put you there. Now, so far, what I know, nothing needs this stuff. So I just need to go into storage. However, the other item I need, which is for the rotors, needs the rods and them. So, I should have this set up like that. Yeah, I think that's all this one needed. Yeah. So screws can now be going from here to there. And I need to get the other rod conveyor port, which is right here, to come out. I'm not sure if I can do that angle. Let's find out. No. No. Well. Now, I wonder what kind of angle I can do. Will that work? No. Maybe I'll move it further back. And. Yeah. There we go. I just need this thing to come this way. Got that there. And I put that down to there. And now I need to make platforms to include their storage devices. It's actually going to be flown by quite a bit, so I'm going to need to go down to make it look, well, a bit more aesthetically pleasing. However, I'm not going to make this place any longer than this. I'm going to extend that way if anything else needs to use the materials these things are making. Yeah, probably best. Yeah, that's lined up. So let's get these into that. And now let's get another one of these. It's lined up like that. Yeah, I like how it actually helps you with alignment. Quite helpful. Okay then, now we need to do is get power over. That's one long power line. But first, before I do that, I need to actually extend my power capacity because I don't have enough capacity to deal with this new load. Because if you go over here, you'll see, getting around 70 odd. And if we go look at these, they require 15 each. Whoa. So two of these are going to be needed. Oh, bugger. It's going to be so much. Oh well, never mind. Put you there. Down to the plates. Well, let's go grab some. And then we're going to fill them. Well, the iron for the rods is backed up. Mainly because the container for the rods is full. Okay, it was full. Not anymore. Oh yeah, that's because I took a bunch out and put them in here. Anyway, let's grab that. That should be sufficient. Get the next one placed down and then link them up. And put fuel in. Boing. And bonk. I think at some point I'll have a better one than this. But anyway, get you, connect to that. You to connect to that. And now I'm going to grab out 6 slots of biofuel. There's plenty here. And go fill everything up. First over here. And a bonk. And a bonk. Oh wait, I will be redoing my entire power system at some point. I'll still keep the biofuel stuff going, but not as much. The main reason for that is that you eventually get coal power, which is significantly better than biofuel, because you can get it mined and put into it. You don't have to worry about making it and transferring it in yourself, which is helpful. Need to put you there. Awesome. I've got plenty of biofuel though, so I still want to keep those going until it's fully burnt up. And again, we use it for the chainsaw. Anywho, now let's get those two things plugged in. So they start making everything that I could possibly get. Boing. Boing. Okay. Now, where am I going to get power from? Do you still have a node? Yes, you do. Hey, I should do one of these first. There should be fine. Over to you. And then from you to that. And then from you to that. Okay. Now it's starting to make things. Now, unfortunately, they will be kind of on the slow side. It's only made one of its thing yet. Come on, hurry up! Still loading up with screws. The screws are now going two separate directions, slowing production down. I could speed up by making a second thing that makes screws, but I don't want to. I'm sure it'll be fine as is. So eventually, this will be full. And thus, it won't need any more screws. As long as I keep it going, anyway. And done. There's one of them. And that's what we're going to use to make this. It isn't. The hell? Oh, whatever. Okay, let's collect what I need to complete the color gun. Then that'll be everything done. Oh. Is there a crash button? No. We need a crash button. I go underneath the conveyors. Okay. Let's go to you. Grab you. I'll be able to use the excess for building things. Wow, you got an awful lot in there. Anyway, need more plates and rods. Boing. Rods are coming out slower. Because there's none left in there. Oh, this is going to be awkward. Considering how much I need. Tree's production line is going to slow down completely. Wait a minute. Why are you stopped? Oh. You're not the plates. That'll be enough of that. Oh well, I guess I'll have to make the rods myself. It's not too bad, because I've got plenty of ingots. Might make a bunch of rods. Just stick it into this system. Nah, it'll be fine. While it will take time to catch up, it should be fine as is right now. So, I'm going to make 100 of these, and then we're going to deliver them. And then get the colour gun. Okay, let's put them there. Put that here. And stick everything else over here this way. Put that there. Stick this here. Launch. Milestone reached. And that's everything finished. Yeah, everything's all done. Color cartridge, which requires flower petals. A color gun. We got some screws. Bye! Okay, let's go and get the screws. Shouldn't be too difficult. Wait, you've got plenty of screws in you already. And I think that'd be more than I'll ever need on me at once. Since I'm only ever going to be making things that need screws directly. I'm not going to be making different things, but different components that need screws. Anyway, I can make 6 of these things. There we go. Now let's get the flower petals out. Plenty of them. Yeah, this coal can go into a coal burner, which will be useful. Ooh, that makes that much. Oh, you make 50 at a time. Cool. And the last few. There we go. Put the rest away. Might put the screws into the system as well. You're gonna stick into that one. And boy. Wait. Do I need it for this? No, I don't. And screws galore! Now, while it will still accept screws, it'll be able to make quite a few before it runs out. That's the only thing slowing this thing down. It's a need for screws. It even tells you its usage per minute. We're still getting the weirdness of these two merging. Still don't know why that happens. Didn't happen anywhere else. Oh well, never mind. This thing's always full. Eventually this will be full. Well, that might actually happen in an hour or two. And copper ore is just stacking. Don't really want to make a container for the ores, because they're not really useful anywhere else. Oh my. So much copper. There's not enough iron. Although, one thing I didn't notice. Wait. Oh, iron rods. Wow, so few iron rods are being made now. Oh, this has slowed down production by a lot. This thing's going slow anyway. And it doesn't even need rods. Meh. Oh well. Wait, will this keep on stacking them up until... Yeah, it's going to keep stacking until there's maximum capacity for it. Which will be 100. Anyway, reload. So, no. Ah, cool. That actually shows what color I can make things. Let's use this for iron things. Which is going to be pretty much everything. But mainly... over here. Eh. Yoink. Now I just need to head over to the other ones. Boing. Boing. That's kind of cool, actually. Boing. Can I click conveyance? Oops, I think I just clicked the thing I was standing on. No, I didn't. The heck? Can I color you? No. Can I color you? Yeah, I can. I'm going to put this thing away. Hey, noodle. What to do next? Oh yeah, the space thing. Don't have a terrace with that yet. So first, add to the to-do list. And now, let's see if I can do anything from here. Nope. Oh, that's a lot of materials I'm going to need. Iron rods are going to be the worst of it. Main place, not too bad. See? Already got them all. Concrete. Oh, wow. New concrete. I'm going to get coils first. I'm going to take you. And I'm going to take you. And you. There we go. I just need to pick up some ingots to make more rods. Plenty, so it should be fine. That may be a bit much. No, wait. One ingot makes one rod, so I'm going to need that. Okay, let's go down and get the concrete. Now the next question is, where to build this space elevator? Because it's not small. See? It's bigger than my current area. I could put it out there. It's gonna have six different ports. It's gonna have things being conveyed in. So I'm thinking of building like a giant platform. Get an extension from there. It's gonna need to be pretty damn big. Wait. Is that actually on the platform? That is on the platform. Wait, seriously? Wow. I need to make it at least 4 more wide. So it'll be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. In 9 by 9 space. Okay. Time to go down and get some concrete. I thought you were gonna end up using it all up. No, show me. Oh my god, I'm gonna die. I need a heal. Me. Made it. The ground comes in a bit closer than I thought it would. Although now I need more concrete. That took an awful lot. I just have to fill in my inventory with concrete. Me. Anyway, I managed to pick up some more stuff for biomass. And biofuel. First of all, let's put them away. And then, put leaves into there. And put wood into there. They are the right places, right? Yeah, yeah. Oh, it's finally emptied itself of all its biomass. And that's got no biomass left. Which means all the biofuel I could possibly have is currently there. I need to switch to coal. I don't have that capability yet. Oh well. I probably will do not long after the space elevator's been made. But I need to go down and grab some concrete. I think I might grab 3 bundles, thus leaving 110 for construction purposes afterwards. Oh, my supply's getting quite low now. Oh well. Well, let's get back up, get into a tower, and build this space elevator. Because it's a pretty cool thing. Boing. We're only on the 5th episode, and we're already building the space elevator. Hi, Moon! You're a big moon. Oh, hi, Red Moon! How many more moons do we have? If you're big, it's either you're larger than this planet, or you're quite close to this planet. It's either one or the other. Oh, I made a platform far larger than it needs to be. Yeah, I can dismantle the excess. May as well get me some materials back, I guess. And a plunk. But I'll do that after we've watched it build. Man, definitely overcalculated its size. Look at the materials fly! I do find that way of having the materials go to the construction to be strange, but still interesting. Ooh, he opens up. And then? It's ready for it. Oh, there it comes. Oh, there it is. Didn't even see the thing start coming down. And now the main rod goes down to plug into it. Huh. That's pretty cool, isn't it? Now what? Right, let's get rid of the excess there that I don't need. Yeah, there's an awful lot. So I guess I now need to go over to it to properly activate it. I got a lot of this stuff to break down though. Right, will I even have enough inventory capacity? Hopefully. Oh, can't reach! Oh well. I sat down without breaking my legs! Ah! This game really is annoying. Oh no, bugger! I need a jetpack! I definitely need a darn jetpack! Just like Dunk from the Ice Cast, light is on my enemy! Ah, balls! There we go. Get out. Yeah, there's not a lot going through to here. But still got 29 in there. As for you, 34. So they are producing, and I think that's more than I'm going to need for quite some time. Wait, do I need 50 of each? Oh yay, let us climb on top of it. And figure the space elevator. Oh, you bugger! Well, I need 75 of them. That shouldn't be too difficult to get a hold of. But I need 50 of those. Nee. Well, for now, I'm going to break down these, and then I'm going to go nab those materials. Because it'll give some of the materials time to actually make. I need to see if I can actually... You know those, like, platform walkways that I made? Over there? I wonder if I can actually make them over here. Because, god dang, getting around this place is difficult. No, I can't. I have to put some walls in first, and a way up to it. Oh well, it'll be worth it. Boing. In fact, can I place stairways in here? Invalid aim location. Well, that works. And so does that. I feel like some of these locations might actually get in the way. Granted, this one... I think that would actually do just fine. It shouldn't be in the way. Let's take a quick look. Nah, it goes straight under. And this leads me to a good spot right on top. That's actually pretty good. And let's see if I can get stairways connected to this. No. I guess I have to make it up a bit higher. Ooh, don't do that. Invalid aim location. Oh. Well, that'll work. Not that useful, though. So, why don't I add it things to my list? That'll make things a bit easier. Anyway. How do I add it to my list? Meh. Oh well. So, let's get the 75 reinforced iron plates first. They should be in there. If not, they'll be in here. Not enough. I got to grab some iron plates and make the rest. In order to get to 75. You don't have 50 yet. So, yeah, I got to grab iron plates to do that. This thing's getting almost full of iron rods. Which means once that's full of iron rods, I'll start backing up on this line. Thus, making more available for other things. Well, considering I've put a ton of screws in there, yeah, it's not going to be short on screws anytime soon. And plus, I need... oh, 6 more of these, that's all I needed. Here we go. Now we get the first stage of the space elevator done. Yeah. I think after this episode I might leave it on for a few hours, just to, you know, process resources. Anyway. Plop you there. Plop you over here. And send. Whee! Up it goes! Bye! Come back soon! Me. So just take out the right up. Wait, there's a message incoming. Oh, jeez. Yeah, I really don't read these, do I? Okay then, I should now have unlocked a couple things. Wait a minute. Oh, I've got a bunch of those. But do I have enough of those cubes? I don't know. I may not actually help make it easier around this place, but I haven't really done much with it. Maybe I should make a platform that goes directly over there. Doesn't seem like a bad idea. But what would I need for such a thing? Me. I know which one will go there. Oh no. Oh, dang it. Well, this is a waste of time. And okay. Now let's go to the thing to get my tier 3 and 4 stuff sorted. Boing, hey boing. Wrong side. Steel production. Heavy modular frame. What the heck? Encase industrial beam. MK2. Extract solid resources from the resource node it is built on. Normal extraction rate is 120 per minute. In other words, this will make my miners even faster. Foundry, smelt 2 resources into an alloy. Oh my. That's going to be interesting. Oh, improved melee. MK3 belt? Storage MK2. Oh my, there's even more storage. Don't need more storage. MK2. I hope this will automatically upgrade. Conveyor pole stackable? Oh, I need that! Fixed size that is stackable. So yeah, this is will actually help you have 2 conveyors going one over the other. But this is what I'm gonna need. Ooh, tractor. A truck station where you can load resources into the tractors. And this is the coal generator, which will allow you to turn coal into power. which I'll be able to replace my biofuel set, because this will be able to power the drill that's mining its resource. Granted, I may need multiple drills mining coal to get enough, although the MK2 will probably help, definitely, well, help it out. But I got a lot of resources to deliver it. Nee! So much. Nee. Anything new in here? No. There's always a beacon. Last thing, I should check the biofuel. See if it's still got plenty. Yeah, they got enough. When they get to like 20 is when I got to really worry about it. You know, I'm gonna make a beacon. I'm gonna go look for some coal. You know, like a source of coal that I can put a drill on. Also, over there is where the Yogscast started. So, yeah, we're not too far from where they began. Any goodle. Maybe I should make the tractor first. I got no more in the special. Yeah, special section's gone. Oh yeah, I won't have the tractor just yet. Need to actually complete this thing first. Yeah, well, at least get the wires and cables in. It's just the other ones may take a little bit of time before they're ready. So, boing. Boing. I'll take that. You're a big bugger. Meh. I can't even make one of those things yet. Wow, you got a lot. Didn't meet the big up there, but oh well. Anywho, let's head back over and deliver them. In fact, I might see how far these have gotten. I'm getting lots of three. Interesting way to divide it up. And no, you've got the cubes. Quite a few of them already. Only 11. Not much. Oh my, too far. Boing. None. How many you got on you? None. You're getting more. Yeah. I guess to make it myself. Oh well, never mind. Let's just put the two things onto here. Onto the list. And then we'll just go collect everything. So I need 25 of these. Oh my, that's gonna require a lot of other materials. And 25 of those. I don't have enough iron rods. For the plates. 100. Okay. Now, how about I go grab several stacks of iron? Now I got 2 stacks of iron ore. Well, iron ingots. Yeah, these things are definitely gonna become full. If I get speed this thing up, it can spit it out even faster. I guess I'll upgrade them after I get the new miners. I'll lift that if I need to. Copper definitely needs upgrading, and that doesn't need a new miner. Anyway. Well, let's get making these rods. The only thing I actually need to make right now. I think I'll make 50 more of these though. Wait, can I make 100? Maybe not. Let's go for these first. Okay, let's put it all in. Yep. That's another one that can be launched. Do that.
Milestone reached. Long-range transportation, as well as the construction of outposts, is now encouraged.
Yay!
Increased focus on the explore and exploit pillar is recommended. Coal is 125% more efficient than biomass and can be automated.
Yep. And now, ooh, workstation. Ah, yeah, that's for loading vehicles. Oh, this one. I need 5 beacons. Hey, ay, ay. I don't have those automated. Okay, let's, the other materials have already been made, so I don't worry too much about that. But the beacons have not. Okay, beacons! Okay, it's the copper coils that I'm short on for that. Let's go grab some more. Yippee! Oh, bugger. Walked straight into the darn thing. Oh god, that stack's getting really small now. Okay. And all I need to do is grab the things I need from the two containers over here. There'll be more than enough in both of them. Yep. And two. Put those there. Two over there. And take them. Now let's make the beacons. And then we'll have ourselves a vehicle, which I'll then go and use to find coal. Wow, I can make a lot of beacons. There we go. Okay. He's diddy. Awesome. Do you have any animation, though? Whoa, it has its own portable thing. It's gonna fuel. It's also storage capacity as well. Which is actually quite handy. But it has no fuel. Okay, how about we do a refueling run? Not like everything actually needs it right now. One, two. How about I just take all this? And start putting all in. And now, let's put all this into its storage. Not sure why it won't let me put all in automatically. Oh well. Okay, plenty of fuel now. Vehicle path. Not recording. Autopilot active, no. Wait, you can make these things automatically drive to places? That's pretty cool. Well, I'm not sure how I'm gonna get it down there. We'll go exploring that way. Oh, maybe that was a route over this way. Okay. So anyway, I think it'll be best if I end this here for now, while I go and explore and find coal. So, I hope you all enjoyed this video. If you have, please leave a like and even subscribe for episodes. And I shall see you all next time. Bye-bye.